गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ मिस्टर सचिन नमदित सवान। एट प्रेजेंट आई एम वर्किंग एज द हेड एंड असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश इन रेज शिक्षण संस्था प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर एन डी पाटिल महाविद्यालय मलकापुर पेरिट तालुका शावाड़ी डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोल्हापुर। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द फेमस प्ले रिटन बाय विलियम शेक्सपियर एंड द टाइटल ऑफ द प्ले इज द कॉमेडी ऑफ एरर्स। This play is prescribed for BA Part 2. Literature and Cinema is the title of this paper. This play is prescribed for Semester 3 and the paper number 3. Now we are going to study this play in detail. The Comedy of Errors is one of the William Shakespeare early plays. It is his shortest and one of his most farcical comedies, with a major part of humor coming from slapsticks and mistaken identity, in addition to puns and wordplay. The Comedy of Errors is, along with The Tempest, one of only two Shakespearean plays to observe the Aristotelian principle of unity of time, that is, the events of a play should occur over 24 hours. The Comedy of Errors, a play, has been adapted for opera, stage, screen and musical theatres numerous times worldwide. In the centuries following its premiere, the play's title has entered the popular English lexicon as an idiom for an event or series of events made ridiculous by the number of errors that were made throughout. Set in the Greek city of Ephesus, the Comedy of Errors tells the story of two sets of identical twins who were accidentally separated at birth, Antipholus of Syracuse and his servant Dromio of Syracuse arrive in Ephesus, which turns out to be the home of their twin brothers Antipholus of Ephesus and his servant Dromio of Ephesus. When the Syracusans encounter the friends and families of their twins, a series of wild mishaps based on mistaken identities lead to wrongful beatings, a near seduction, the arrest of Antipholus of Ephesus, and fall, accusation of infidelity, theft, madness, and demonic possession. There are good numbers of characters in the play. Some characters are divided into major characters and some characters are divided into minor characters. Now we are going to see, this is the list of the characters is given: Solonus, Duke of Ephesus; Eugene, a merchant of Syracuse, father of Antipholus' twins; Emilia, Antipholus' lost mother, wife to Eugene; Antipholus of Ephesus, Antipholus of Syracuse, twin brother, son of Eugene and Emilia; Dromio of Ephesus and Dromio of Syracuse, twin brothers, bondmen, each serving his respect to Antipholus; Andriana, wife of Antipholus of Ephesus; Luciana, Andrea's sister. There are also another important characters in the play: Nell, Luce, kitchen maid to Andriana; Balthazar, a merchant; Angelio, a goldsmith; Curtizan, first merchant friend to Antipholus of Syracuse, second merchant to whom Angelio is in debt; Dr. Pinch, conjuring schoolmaster, headsman, officers and other attendants. These are the important characters in the play. Now we are going to study the act-wise summary of the play Comedy of Errors. Because a law forbids merchants from Syracuse to enter Ephesus, elderly Syracusans trader Eugene faces execution when he is discovered in the city. He can only escape by paying a fine of 1,000 marks. He tells his sad story to Solonus, Duke of Ephesus. In his young, Eugene married and had twin sons. On the same day, a poor woman without a job also gave birth to twin boys, and he purchased these as a slave to his sons. Soon afterward, the family made a sea voyage and was hit by a tempest. Eugene lashed himself to the mainmast with one son and one slave, and his wife took the other two infants. His wife was rescued by one boat, Eugene by another. Eugene never again saw his wife or the children with her. Recently, his son Antipholus, now grown, his son's slave Dromio left Syracuse to find their brothers. When Antipholus did not return, Eugene set out in search of him. The Duke is removed by this story and grants Eugene one day to pay his fine. That same day, Antipholus arrives in Ephesus searching for his brother. He sends Dromio to deposit some money at the Centurion Inn. He is confounded when the identical Dromio of Ephesus appears almost immediately, denying any knowledge of the money and asking him alone to dinner where his wife is waiting. Antipholus, thinking his servant is making insubordinate jokes, beats Dromio of Ephesus. Now, in Act number 2, we are going to study the further story. The story automatically gets developed, and let's see what happens in Act number 2. Dromio of Ephesus returns to his mistress Adriana, saying that her husband refused to come back to his house and even pretended not to know her. Adriana, concerned that her husband's eye is straying, takes this news as confirmation of her suspicions. Antipholus of Syracuse, who complains, "I could not speak with Dromio since at first I sent him from the mart," meets up with the Dromio of Syracuse, who now denies making a joke about Antipholus having a wife. Antipholus begins beating him. Suddenly, Adriana rushes up to Antipholus of Syracuse and begs him not to leave her. The Syracusans cannot but attribute these strange events to witchcraft, remarking that Ephesus is known as the Warren for witches. Antipholus and Dromio go up with this strange woman, the one to eat dinner and the other to keep the gate. Now we are going to study what happens in the play in Act number 3. Let's see the summary of the play, that is A Comedy of Error, in Act number 3. Antipholus of Ephesus returns home for dinner and is enraged to find that he is rudely repulsed into his own house by Dromio of Syracuse, who is keeping the gate. He is ready to break down the door, but his friends persuade him not to make a scene. He decides instead to dine with the courtesans. Inside the house, Antipholus of Syracuse discovers that he is very attracted to his wife's sister Luciana of Smyrna, telling her, "Train me not, sweet mermaid, with the eye note, to drown me in thy sister's flood of tears." He is flattered by his attention but worried about their moral implications. After she exists, Dromio of Syracuse announces that he has discovered that he has a wife, named Hideous Kitchen Maid. He describes further, we are going to study the detailed information about the play Comedy of Errors in Act number 3. The Syracusans decide to leave as soon as possible, and Dromio runs off to make travel plans. Antipholus of Syracuse is then confronted by Angelio of Ephesus, a goldsmith, who claims that Antipholus ordered a chain from him. Antipholus is forced to accept the chain, and Angelio says that he will return for payment. Now we are going to see what happens in Act number 3, and now we are going to study what happened in Act number 4. This is the story so far we have seen. Now we are going to study the Act number 4 here. Antipholus of Ephesus dispatches Dromio of Ephesus to purchase a robe so that he can beat his wife Adriana for locking him out. Then he is accosted by Angelio, who tells him, "I thought to have taken you at the Porpentine and asked to be reimbursed for the chain." He denies ever seeing it and is prompt promptly arrested as he is being led away. Dromio of Syracuse arrives, whereupon Antipholus dispatches him back to Andriana's house to get money for his bail. After completing this errand, Dromio of Syracuse mistakenly discovers the money to Antipholus of Syracuse. The courtesan spies Antipholus wearing the gold chain and says he promised it to her in exchange for her ring. The Syracusans deny this and flee. The courtesan resolved to tell Andriana that her husband is insane. Dromio of Ephesus returns to the arrested Antipholus of Ephesus with the rope. Antipholus is infuriated. Andriana, Luciana, and the courtesan enter with the conjurer named Pinch, who tries to exorcise the Ephesians, who are bound and taken to Andriana's house. The Syracusans enter carrying swords, and everybody runs off for fear, believing that they are the Ephesians out for vengeance after somehow escaping their bonds. Now we are going to see what happens in act number 5. This is the last act of the play. Andriana reappears with henchmen who attempt to bind the Syracusans. They take sanctuary in a nearby priory, where the abbess resolutely protests them. Suddenly, the abbess enters with the Syracusan twins, and everyone begins to understand the confused event of the day. Not only are the two sets of twins reunited, but the abbess reveals that she is Eugene's wife, Emilia of Babylon. The Duke pardons Eugene. All exits into the abbey to celebrate the reunification of the family. This is the ending of the play. That is a happy ending. Thanks for watching the entire video, for your support and cooperation.